From the technologies that might be invented to the political structure of things and how human life as a whole will grow, allow us to show you what 2030 might be like. To start, let's look at the world as it is right now in 2021. In short, it's not exactly the best place for all sorts of reasons. There's of course the pandemic that absolutely ravaged the world and is still doing that for the record, the tensions between nations, between the government and its people, and of course a very strong desire for equality among all races and orientations makes turning on the news a bit tenuous, as you all know that something bad is going to be talked about, including many things that we didn't even mention. And there's no doubt that there's going to be many of these issues still when we get to 2030. So is there really something to look forward to in all of that? Well, yes, even if it doesn't seem like it at first. For example, one thing that more than likely will have happened by 2030 is the first manned mission to Mars. We say this because as of right now, both NASA and SpaceX are working on making this happen right now. In fact, they're already doing massive tests to see just how viable some of their crafts are in terms of their ability to get to Mars. SpaceX especially has gone and made great strides in the Mars mission because they were the ones who have tried to make it happen for almost two decades now. SpaceX was built by Elon Musk to go and invigorate the space race once again, and they've succeeded in doing that. According to Elon Musk, the goal is to have a craft ready to send to Mars in the next few years. Colonizing Mars in full won't happen until much later, but as far for 2030, by that time, barring certain difficulties and accidents on missions of course, we could find ourselves celebrating not just getting to Mars, but going there multiple times. Because the goal is not a one-off trip. They want to test themselves getting there, living there for a little while, coming back, and then going back to the Red Planet within a fair span of time to start the colonizing process. Musk himself has noted many times on Twitter that he wants a fully colonized home on Mars by 2050. And if SpaceX really does get us to Mars by 2030, that dream will be very much intact. But that's a little far from home, wouldn't you say? So what about all the things here on Earth that will likely be happening by 2030? Well, ironically, a big thing that hopefully will have happened by 2030 is a huge overhauling of power supplies across the planet, from fossil fuels to green energy. And if you're thinking, isn't that something Elon Musk is doing? Yes. Yes, it is. Because if you look at our world right now in 2021, Elon Musk via his company Tesla, as well as other companies who are following suit, are working hard to not just make electric cars, but get them distributed all over the world. Tesla has been doing this since the early 2000s, but only in recent years have they seen not just a boom in success, but people willing to try them out. Furthermore, Elon Musk is making gigafactories to go and make even more of the cars so that they can fit the demand that is growing. So what does this have to do with converting to green energy, you ask? Simple, it has everything to do with it. Because one of the biggest polluters in the world today aren't the factories that make things or the homes we live in. It's the vehicles we drive. There are approximately 1.4 billion cars in the world right now. And while it's fair to say that not all of them are driven every single day, every time we drive them, we pollute the area in massive quantities. Switching to electric cars eliminates that part of the fossil fuel problem. It'll take a while to convert everyone, but in 9 years' time, that's a lot of potential electric cars out on the road. Furthermore, many nations of the world, including the United States, now that President Joe Biden leading the nation, are aiming to go and eliminate as many fossil fuels from their processes of life by 2030 and beyond. So we won't be in a cleaner world, mind you, but every step in every single year that we live in matters. So by 2030, we might be able to severely curb or even severely drop the fossil fuel usage that we have, which would be a big step indeed. Before we continue to break down how 2030 looks, be sure to like or dislike the video. And let us know how you think we can improve so we can give you the best videos possible. Another reason that green energy conversion is important is because another major element when it comes to 2030 is the cities that we live in. How so? Well, if you take a look around the world, especially in places like China, Hong Kong, the United Arab Emirates, and more, construction is going on at a massive rate, mainly because many of these nations are looking to revolutionize their cities to be both more modernized as well as be futurized in their own way. A great example of this can be very easily found in the UAE, because the UAE has been overhauling Dubai for years in order to convert it from just a popular Middle East city and the home of certain religious attractions to being a place of pure tourism and changing the perception of the UAE as a whole. If you don't believe us, take a look at how Dubai looked even just a decade or so ago, and how it looks now. They're constantly and consistently going and building themselves new buildings to sell space in, new attractions for people to go and see, and even building man-made islands in order to fit more of their attractions in there. China is doing this on a different scale, as they're trying to modernize their cities so that they can fit their rapidly growing population. In recent years, they've even made a giant bridge to Hong Kong to help expedite delivery of goods and to help ferry people across the body of water that separates them much faster. As if all of that wasn't enough, the rapper known as Akon is taking the idea of a future city to new levels in Senegal, as he's gotten permission to go and build a multi-billion dollar city within the nation that'll rival the size of its capital, and yet be able to be run completely on cryptocurrency. It'll have places to live, plenty of places to work, and be able to accommodate all sorts of people in order to fit their needs. Should this work, more cities like it will be built throughout Africa. So just in terms of how cities look, 2030 could be very different in certain parts of the world. But let's also look at a certain other thing we just mentioned, cryptocurrency. You see, right now the desire to go and use cryptocurrency like Bitcoin, Dogecoin, and other entities like it is a bit mixed between those who are willing to risk it, and many have made millions off of that, and then those who feel that this digital currency is nothing but a con job, which has been proven in certain ways by the volatility of the amount that cryptocurrency has. However, despite the mixed feelings, more and more people, especially big-time business people like Mark Cuban and Elon Musk, are buying into this, and the results of this could lead to a wave of major businesses and even governments converting to cryptocurrency. They logically won't do this in full, as that's a risky endeavor. But by 2030, you're going to likely find a lot of people dealing just in cryptocurrency of various types rather than dealing with paper cash. What else is there to look forward to in 2030? Well, let's talk the potential of medicines by the time the new decade comes around. Because right now, as the pandemic continues to rage on, a lot of eyes are on medicines to try and help us contain and resist the virus that has taken the lives of many. The problem is that medicine is a science, but not an exact one in terms of when we'll figure things out. The pandemic vaccine, for example, in normal time, wouldn't have come out for years, but concentrated efforts were put out to go and make sure it got made so people could be cured, and even then sometimes there were issues, like the recent Johnson & Johnson vaccine pausing. However, there are some who are in the mindset that by 2030, we'll have not just better medical procedures, we'll be able to go and do fixing on a genetic level. Yes, we're talking about gene editing. Technically speaking, we already have gene editing right now, as there are some hospitals and clinical trials that are able to do gene editing on a certain level, and only in very specific circumstances. But as years go on, and those trials and tests expand, the possibilities are endless, and that's what many in the medical and science field are trying to achieve. Because think of it like this. Instead of having a multi-step vaccine, you can have your genes edited to go and naturally resist all non-natural bioprocesses. Sounds pretty nice, right? Plus, with the advent of new technology, which grows every single year, we find ourselves with the possibility of new advances in medicine that we likely can't even picture for now. Who knows? We might even have a cure for all types of cancer by 2030. And that would be quite a thing, wouldn't you agree? Speaking of new technologies, many people are of course wondering about the entertainment features that we are likely to go and have when the next decade comes. Because right now we have TVs that go and display pictures in 4K, and it's a beautiful thing. but where can we go from there? The question here is one of immersion, and many companies are already working on that via VR headsets to truly let you feel like you're part of something. But as technology advances, there's little doubt that they're going to go more digital and less hardware. By that, we're talking about holographic projections of the movie or show you're watching or video game you're playing. Imagine instead of watching a movie on whatever size TV you have, you can just project a holographic screen of the size you want and the distance you want it from your position. Exactly. No more having to get closer to the TV when the TV can go and get closer to you. There's also some who believe that the programs could eventually be beamed directly to your eyes to really get you up close and personal with the program. Then there's holograms that you might be able to interact with should the right technology come along. But the obvious question about futuristic technology is that of AI, artificial intelligence. Will we really be at a place in time where they are just not super advanced, but everywhere? More than likely, yes. There's already AI in the world right now, and it's getting smarter every day, to the point that some of them know how to understand your patterns and even help you in ways you wouldn't expect them to. Some predict that by 2030, we'll be each having our own AI companion to go and use for whatever needs we may have. Sure, this might lead to Skynet eventually, but by 2030, they're likely to be just dumb enough to help out. Obviously, there's a lot of things we haven't talked about, including all the bad things that are likely to be with us still in 2030. Injustice, inequality, a wasting of natural resources, waste that is just piled up in landfills. It's a lot. And hopefully by 2030, some of those things will be dealt with. But there are things that is for certain. The world will be more advanced in 2030. It's just the question of what things will be advanced first. Thanks for watching. What did you think of this look at 2030 and how things might look in 9 years' time? Which of these advances or endeavors do you feel might honestly come true? Or are we overestimating what is going to happen? Let us know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and we'll see you next time on the channel.